Welcome back to the final part for Cape Canardo, which will be Space Station Meer. Now, before I get started, I'll just want to say that you should probably transform into Bungalow before you start Space Station Meer, seeing as there's quite a few tokens that are in like an out of reach place if you're playing as anyone else. So I'll just basically make my way to the auditorium area at the back there and just quickly transform into him. Oh god, Bungalow's just been incinerated. Oh, this has went terribly. No, that's just the transition. So here we are on Space Station Meer itself, and you can see the lovely purple sky outside, and see some more booster rockets. I think that's the shuttle that we came on. And the Bungalow Baby, which, believe it or not, is right at the exit of the level. Through that hatch at the back there is the exit to the level, but we've got quite a bit of distance to travel and circumnavigate before we can even think about getting close to that baby. So this is going to be like the main atrium area that connects everything. There's basically only four doors. There's this door here, which I'll probably refer to as number one. And through there is basically where we're wanting to go. But just for the sake of clarity, I'll show where the other, or what the other passages lead to. So through this one here, which is number three, there's basically this door here, and this is like the exit to the level. As I was saying earlier, but we can't get through just yet.
The next room has been depressurized, comrade. You'll have to find some oxygen before entering.
And this is basically the marker, so that you know how many oxygen canisters you've found. You've got to find a total of four. It does beg the question, if the room's been depressurized, then how's that Bungalow Baby alive? Must have some secret oxygen on it that we don't know about. But anyway, that's basically the exit to the level, and we'll be collecting those four canisters shortly across the entire level. And then through here, we basically have another door here.
The reactor needs to be at full power before door can open, comrade.
And it would be easier if they'd done that themselves, but of course there wouldn't be a puzzle if they did that. So we'll be getting to that a little bit later on. There's two tokens here, but just for the sake of, like, since we're coming back through this way anyway, I'll basically just leave them till the end. So to begin with, door number one. And we meet this little chap here. Let's see what he wants.
Do svidaniya, comrade. I am gyroscope control meercat. I control rotation of space station. Don't tell others, but I left gyroscopic coordinates on my desk in Cape Conardo. Now I have to keep bears and small child in this room, so station remains correctly balanced.
Do svidaniya means goodbye, though. I wonder if anyone told them that. Anyway, besides the point, so basically there's a bunch of bears in here along with another Bungalow Baby that we have to rescue. We do need to find a set of gyroscopic coordinates, and we'll be doing that a little bit later on, and coming back through here and then giving them to that little guy there. Bit of an ambush on this side. Nothing to worry about though. However, there are quite a few more that pour through that hatch there. And then somehow we get more that spawn from behind us, even though we just cleared out the room that we're in. A little bit confusing, but anyway. The reason that I said you want to start as bungalow is basically for these tokens up here. As anyone else, you won't be able to jump high enough, even though we're in space. Sorry. You still need bungalow in order to jump up super duper high to get up here. And it's kind of incredible just how far you can actually make with just like one... Oh, smashing into the geometry there. How far you can actually go with just like one jump from bungalow. I mean, quick demonstration, like, easily make it to the other side of this room. I mean, there's just no contest. The other characters do jump pretty far as well, but I mean, obviously bungalow can jump higher and further, so there's really no contest. Now, this room down here, if you want, there is basically a secret tunnel. See if I can make it in. There we go. So there's basically a secret tunnel down here. However, I don't know how you're supposed to get through. I can see from there that you're supposed to use Chang since it's a like small gap. The problem, however, is that I think it's tied to like this door here. So you're probably, you'll have to transform into Chang, and then there'll be a bit of a delay on the, like, the door opening, of course. In fact, I might have actually just solved that puzzle myself without even thinking about it. Yeah, and the door closes, so you kind of have to be quick on the draw. Yeah, I don't think you're supposed to make that. You're probably supposed to use Chang. However, when I was trying to do this before, like, Chang would basically make it up onto that inclined ridge there, and he would kind of just float there. He wouldn't be able to jump high enough to be able to make it in. So for the purposes of just getting through this walkthrough, I've probably wasted enough time. That's pretty much all you're going to get if you want to go in there, but there's no like improved weapons or anything like that, so there's really no point going for it any longer. I will be staying as bungalow for pretty much the entirety of this video until all of the puzzles have been solved, and then I'll basically just quickly double back through the entire level and rescue the other babies that we need. There's two Rufus babies in this level and there's two bungalow babies. Three of them are on this space station and one of them's a little bit like right outside the exit of the level, but I'll show you that when we get to it. To begin with, or to continue though, let's basically see what this chap wants now.
They tell me to watch for asteroid showers. They are never any at this time of day. At least I have job. Don't fear, comrade. Nothing exciting ever happened here. I go for a little lie down.
You know, that sounds awesome. I think I'm actually going to join you now. Oh god. Right, okay, what do we do? I'm just kidding, I've done this before. Basically open this hatch here, and as it foreshadowed, you basically got to take care of this asteroid shower, which is hurtling towards the space station at a rate of knots. Now, if even one tiny chunk of these rocks makes it to the actual space station itself, then you'll basically see quite a well detailed destruction of the entire thing here, but hopefully that doesn't happen. Or maybe it just is about to. Yep. I don't think real space stations blow up with that much vigour, but it's certainly a good fireworks display to look at. Unfortunately, we get punted all the way back to the start of the level, so I'm just going to like try and quickly get through all of these enemies here without spending too much time on them, since it just it takes a little bit too much time to constantly kill them. It does mean that you're going to have to watch this cutscene again. You can skip it, obviously, or you can skip the dialogue at least.
Don't fear. I go for a little lie down.
That sounds great. I'm going to join you. Oh no. Anyway, take two. It did take me three times before I was able to do this before, so maybe it's just inherently difficult, I suppose. The annoying thing is that you can't really aim, and I've already messed this up. The annoying thing is that you can't really aim that well since you don't have crosshairs, which again is to be expected, but you do obviously have like three separate cannons, which is nice, but trying to line up without crosshairs or like any sort of guidance at all, you're kind of just like tweaking the controls back and forth until you find the right line, and then at that point it's usually too late. But anyway, it took me three times before, so hopefully third time's the charm with this one.
Don't fear, comrade. I go for a little lie down.
Oh, come on. It is a little bit bad for that, I must say, like, not immediately killing you. I mean, it's the tiniest of chunks of rock, like, the actual space station Meer kind of. That had an entire space shuttle crash into it at quite a relatively high velocity. It was going far faster than it should have been going, put it that way. And it only had like a busted solar panel or something like that. I mean, it survived. It wasn't as if the entire thing blew up. But anyway.
Don't. I go for a little lie down.
Or I should probably say, just to get my facts straight with the whole Space Station Meer thing, that was one of the accidents that happened to it. It was like, they were trying to dock the space station, or the space station, they were trying to dock the shuttle onto the actual space station itself. However, they tried to do it manually, if I remember correctly, because the guidance systems that they were using were like not working or something like that. And it was like kind of impossible to do with any great precision, like trying to keep the speed correct and everything. Oh man, Jesus. I do apologize for how abysmal this is going. I think at this point I'm probably, since this is like the fifth time, I'm probably just going to like fast forward through most of the boring parts, and then I'll just, if this ends up taking like even more time than this attempt here, then I'm probably just going to fast forward through the rest of the fails and then just quickly like show the actual one, like the successful one. But anyway, yeah, like the space, like the actual shuttle itself, it was supposed to like dock, but they didn't have the guidance systems, as far as I remember. And then, like the astronaut had to do the docking procedure manually, but it approached far too quickly for what it should have been going. And then it kind of was out of control at that point, and then it like battered into the side of it and left quite a serious dent, enough to basically activate the decompression alarm system. So there was basically an air leak on the actual space shuttle itself, and if they didn't like correct it or fix it in time, then they would basically, the entire space station would be like, you know, in a complete vacuum more or less, and then everyone on board would have died. Thankfully that didn't happen though, to the best of my knowledge. Hey! Awesome. Okay, maybe I won't edit anything out then. Just taking care of these bears first though. Oh no, that's not what I meant to do. That is a very genuine and heavy sigh, because now getting some of the tokens in the canisters, like at the, like further on into this level, are going to be quite tricky, so I'm going to have to go and find the bungalow transform again. I believe it's in like the second hydroponic dome that we're about to approach, but that's like added on a couple of minutes, I didn't want to. Anyway, get this space shuttle thing finished off. I believe they were able to repair it, or like, obviously I don't know I just know the general details and stuff like that. But everything went okay, but then it eventually got decommissioned in like 2001, if I remember right, and they basically just had a control burn up into Earth's atmosphere now, and all the debris basically scattered into, it was like the South Pacific Ocean or something like that. I'm going off what Wikipedia says right here, but the general details are more or less correct. But anyway, enough waffling, back to the walkthrough. So we have all those tokens to begin with. Keep getting ambushed by bear for some reason, not entirely sure why. So much like the VLF facility, we basically have these hydroponic domes here. Could have been some space science of sorts, and it's the best kind of science. And in each of these like hydroponic domes, you're going to have quite a bulk of tokens. And as you might be able to hear, there's a new enemy type, and this one can be quite annoying, seeing as how you can't see it. That little lizard thing there that's thrashing its tongue at me. Oh, look at that shot. That's cool. So those enemies are basically completely invisible up until the moment that they like lash their tongue out at you trying to attack you. So that can be quite annoying because you obviously can't see where they are, and you're kind of just waiting for the target reticle to turn red before you can deal with them. But like you just saw there, the quickest way I find to deal with them is basically just spend the thermal energy to freeze them in place, and then quickly switch to your melee attack or any other gun and just shatter them to pieces. I'll just collect a bunch of tokens at the bottom here. 24 now, unless I'm... yes, I've missed the two tokens that are behind the door at the top there. There should be a total of 12 tokens in this first hydroponic dome. There's 10 on the floor there, and then there's these two behind the door. And as you can see and hear over there, there's basically a Rufus baby that is next to a couple of gold tokens. However, the platform at which it's standing on is like far too high for Rufus to reach. Bungalow could do it no problem, but that's obviously no use. We come across a giant space gherkin. Keep out of direct sunlight. So obviously the first thing that we want to do is to try and get direct sunlight onto this gherkin here. And we should have some interesting consequences for doing so, but we'll get to that in a second. So with the first dome done, you can basically just navigate your way to the second dome, which is behind this yellow door here. And for this second dome, you have 11 tokens. One on top, which is basically this one here. You've got a peacock to deal with. and another 10 tokens that are scattered around here. However, we have these annoying plant things. Again, we don't, unlike in the VLF facility where we had to basically freeze them in order to get past, these ones are relatively simple to just navigate through if you just keep running as fast as you possibly can and potentially like strafing to the side. You should be able to avoid their attack, because they'll basically be attacking you where you are, not where you're going to be. And it does take them a little bit to like reset into the upright position before they can attack again, so you should be able to dodge it without too much hassle. And again, 10 tokens on the bottom, so we're basically looking for to have a total of 37 at this point, after the last three there. And again, bungalows jump so high you don't even need the ladders, you can basically just jump up there, it's absolutely awesome. And we move into the third hydroponic dome, where they've managed to get it to snow in here, which is pretty awesome. Again, two peacocks up here, just quickly deal with that, and then down here and get some more health. Take care of these guys here. Freeze it this time. Again, that's kind of incredible. Twice in a row I've managed to do that. Anyway, enough self-praising. So there's the one token that's on the top, and then there's another 8 that are scattered around here. They're mostly in the middle here. And this part, as you can no doubt see, is ice, so that's why you're probably going to be skating across it instead of moving in a straight line. So we should have a total of 46 by the time that we're done here, and I'll just pick up the health since I probably won't be coming back through here again without full health, hopefully. And the last token for 46, cool. So the other thing to point out, as you can hopefully see in the reflection here, is this O2 canister, and that's one of the ones that we're wanting. However, it's basically underneath this like thick sheet of ice at the moment, so we're going to have to find some way to thaw it. So if only we could find a way to expose it to direct sunlight. That gives me a great idea. And it just so happens that the button that we need is right in front of us. Two tokens here.
Warning, hydroponic domes opening.
Oh, it's so bright. Cool, so with that, the sunlight opens and this entire sheet of ice here thaws into this nice puddle. And we pick up our first oxygen canister. Now, of course, we could go back, and again, this area is quite annoying because you're basically going to slide down all of these walls here. There's really, like, there's this area here that you can, like, climb up, but the quickest way to get it is just to jump out. You could, at this point, go all the way back to the start of the level where the asteroid shower cannons were, transform into Rufus, and then go and rescue that baby. I'm just going to leave that until the end, because we're basically going to loop back around there anyway, so I'm just going to keep going forward with the level, and then we'll basically get back to it at the end. So we come in here, putting on a few bears to take care of. Last one is, oh dear, didn't mean to do that. That is one of the slight annoying things, and there isn't like an option menu to turn it off, where you basically, whenever you deplete the gun's ammo, or the gun that you're currently using's ammo, it will basically automatically snap to the best gun, which it does in terms of just like what's furthest to the right at this moment, whether or not it's actually best for the situation. So it's kind of preferable to avoid doing that if at all possible. But anyway, four tokens in this room, two at the front, two at the back, and another oxygen canister at the top here. And then next up, we'll basically just make our way through this door here. Now we have two options. Again, we have a left door and we have a right door. The right door leads you into this scary looking thing here. With some more cows that are launching fire at you. That's basically the reactor room that we were talking about earlier that has to be at full power. And then when you come in here, you've got another two tokens to the side there, but you've also got this scary looking thing. Which is basically, it's kind of like the world's best telescope for this level, because this gives you an entire overview of like what Furfighter Village kind of looks like if you were able to find it on this map. But anytime, you'll see that when the square's blue and you try and like hit X, you'll basically have a no target sign. However, when it turns orange, you can hit fire and then it will automatically zoom in on a certain point of interest. So you can see here the World Quack Center from the first world, and then if we take a trip southwest, you can zoom in on the Beaver Dam. A little out of frame, but that's fine. And then if we go down south, telescope is that powerful that we can actually read the coordinates off the guy's desk, which is quite handy for us. And then we also have another Cape Canaveral building here. If we zoom in quite a lot, we can see a Rufus baby. This is the one that I was talking about at the start, and we're only really going to get that when we like finish up the level, but I'll get to that shortly. And then we make a trip to the northeast and we kind of see a whole lot of nothing, but that's actually the jungle area for the fifth world, and to basically just show what the last world is going to be, we basically have this carrier here, which is the Viggo or the HMS Vigolino or whatever it's called, that was seen at the like very very start of the game. When all the Furfighter babies were captured. But that's basically just a little, not Easter egg I suppose, but you know, you can just have a look at how the geometry of everything fits together. So you would have to assume, of course, that like Furfighter Village is like somewhere in the middle here to be able to like access all these areas, or maybe it's behind this mountain area here. But regardless, once you're done, you can just hit the jump button and then ta-da! We get a set of gyroscopic coordinates. And now with the gyroscopic printout, we can basically, we could return to the meercat that was at the very start of the level and go rescue the bungalow baby, but again, we're going to be getting back to that shortly, so basically just take a trip in here through the reactor, and then we can just loop round right to the start of the level. Now there are two flamethrower cows in here. I So what I'll do is I'll collect the tokens first on both the upper and the lower levels before like going any further. So if you fall down here, it does look a wee bit scary, but there's nothing apart from just a few bears down here that you have to take care of and a couple of tokens. But also, we have another oxygen canister to get. Cool, so the two tokens, found those at the bottom here, and we have the canister, so now basically just climb back up this ladder again. So basically this door, like we saw right at the start, this has to be at full power before we can go any further. So we're going to have to mess around with some of these buttons here. Now the problem is that some of them will cause the reactor to overheat and some of them will cause the reactor to underheat. Now I assume that the reason that they put those four bars up there is because that's basically saying that both of these have to be at their absolute highest. However, what I've found to be far, far quicker is if you hit this button here, and then you hit this button here, that should have worked. Why didn't that work?
Danger, reactor overloading.
Now the very first time that I did this, I basically pressed both of those buttons and then that was enough to restore full power. So I'm not entirely sure why it hasn't worked.
Danger, reactor failure, life support failure imminent.
Well, I must say this is quite interesting, because definitely the last time that I done this, just a case of hitting that one and then that one. There we go.
The reactor is now at full power coverage.
I got my buttons messed up. I was thinking that it was these two buttons here, when in fact it was this button and that button. Cool. So, little mishap on my part, but you can, if you don't know, you're basically just trying to... To be honest, I'm not even sure what you're supposed to be doing, because it looked like it was running comfortably well the last time, so you've like kind of got to increase the power of the reactor without it spinning out of control. But anyway, just those two buttons there and then that'll be it. Now, through this little tunnel area here, you're going to have like two roach things that are going to be firing at you. I would say at this point, this is probably a good point to use the smart gun, if you can time it right and catch both of them at the same time. Perfect. Of course, you could just shoot them with the heavy machine gun or with the plasma blaster or anything like that, but I would say that's a pretty good time to use it. And then come into here, and we do have another two bears that are scattered around this part here. Just take them out mid-air. Added cool points. So in this room, in addition to that beetle shield that is up there, there's a bunch of tokens that are on top of these computer things, and there's also another oxygen canister that we have to get, so...
Hello, please
So of course you're going to want to basically lower this handle here. This super duper helpful box basically comes towards us and fixes everything. But you'll want to quickly you'll quickly want to just jump onto the box and then jump up here before it moves back again. And then it does take quite a while to make that box reset and then to have it come all the way over here. So if you can avoid falling off of these things, I would certainly say that's helpful, since it'll save you a lot of time. And that's the final oxygen canister, so with that we'll basically just move on to the next area here. Dun dun dun!
Hold it right there, bud. I'm a copyright lawyer from 31st Century Films, and this creature violates at least 7 of our copyrights.
I know, speak your language. Do you speak of the English?
You're just making it worse for yourself. I guess we'll just have to deal with this the old-fashioned way.
Incredible that they managed to get 2 references in there in short succession. It's quite an amazing scene. Anyway, mini boss time. And this guy has an obscene amount of health. Like, it's kind of like I've just emptied the entire heavy machine gun amount there, and then I'm probably just going to blast through this entire amount of plasma energy as well, and he's probably still not going to die. But if you can keep him constantly suspended in this... No, we did kill him. Cool. If you keep him constantly suspended in like a state of always being hit, then he shouldn't be able to shoot back at you, because he's crazy accurate. And as you saw there, I took 2 like shots which caused the beetles to disappear whilst he was still kind of like suspended in that animation of being shot. So you will take quite a lot of damage if you're not you know, constantly shooting them. Oh. Anyway. So we have a few more tokens at this point. Oh dear. There is really no sense in jumping into that fray and getting ambushed. You may as well just take care of them from outside here, where it's relatively safe. Out of that ammo as well. I'll have to restock soon. So, with all of that done, we basically come through this door here, and we can now see that it's basically got green, and this is the one that I was talking about right at the start of the video, as you've probably remembered. And with that, we basically pour back out into here. Now, we could go and put the 4 oxygen canisters in, and then beyond that, when you open up that big door and you go through it, is basically a couple more tokens, a bungalow baby, and then the exit to the level. So what I will do first, before we trigger that, is basically chuck in these coordinates to him.
Station is now correctly balanced, comrade. I have no need for this load of Bolsheviks anymore.
Uh oh. Transforming just because I think there's the possibility that I might have died if I was to continue fighting them any longer, but thankfully we didn't. Another couple of tokens, and unfortunately now we have to go back and... Oh dear, where'd you come from? Must say this isn't looking good. Yep. Oh well. We've died before at this point, we're practically shrugging it off. So, come through here. What I may as well do is transform into Rufus, and what we can do is basically go rescue the Rufus baby that's in like the first hydroponic dome, and then proceed to transform into Bungalow, and then we can again make our way back around again. The problem, of course, as with many levels that have like buttons that trigger stuff, as soon as you die, everything gets reset, or some parts get reset, depending on that. Sometimes, like these peacocks that were up here, and the enemies below, they haven't reset, but the actual buttons that were used to trigger stuff has actually reset, and as you can see here, the ice layer has formed again. Thankfully, we keep the... I'm going to show the inventory here. You keep all the... like the items that you've collected up to that point, but the hydroponic dome, like skylight things, need to be reopened again, annoyingly. And then we see the light, and then let's see this again. Thankfully, with the low space, or the not the low space, the low gravity, can make it back all the way through here with relatively little trouble. We can make large jumps that cut a bit of the time out. Not much, though, I suppose. So we basically make it all the way back through here again, and then one jump onto the gherkin, and then from there. We completely missed because we weren't close enough. And just make it up. So now we have to, there's the ladder about, we have to make our way back into the second hydroponic room in order to transform into Bungalow, and then once we transform into Bungalow we can go rescue both of his babies on this part, and then basically take the space shuttle, like once we're about to leave this area we can leave the shuttle and then rescue the last baby, and then that'll be us. Make sure I haven't missed anything. Good. Drive.
Thank you for retrieving gyroscopic codes. I think bears were planning revolution.
Just as many like quick references and digs that they can get at the Russians on this level. I think that was the entire aim of this level, to be honest. So with that baby rescued, we now have a shortcut that leads all the way back round. Not all the way around, but to this room here, the third room. This is where we basically put the canisters in.
The room is now at normal atmospheric pressure.
And with that, come in here. And unfortunately, we have missed a token. Or I've missed a token, rather. So what I will do is I probably will edit this part out, since there's no sense in watching this entire area. However, with it being only a single token, I think it might be towards the start of the video. Towards the start of the video, towards the start of the level. So what I will do is basically just quickly trek through this entire part here and see what one I've missed. No doubt it's probably, it might even be one token that was in the hydroponic domes, but I'm pretty sure I collected all of those, so. And we're back. Absolutely unbelievable. I completely blank on the one token. Like, I knew something was wrong when I entered this room, because I remember collecting the two there, and then there was the four here, but I had it in my notes that there was eight that had to be collected in total. But I thought that I must have counted it wrong, so that's a total fail on my part. I do apologise for that, but I probably will have fast-forwarded through all of that, so you don't have to spend too much time watching it. But with that done, we can now navigate our way back to the start of the level. Or rather, to this oxygen room here. Now, there is a Rufus baby at the end, but you don't actually have to transform into Rufus before you enter, and I should probably say, as soon as you step over like that line, as soon as you get like one toe over that line, or like get anywhere near it, then you basically have this escape shuttle thing that basically jetties off of the actual thing, and then we're back into this puzzle again. Similar to what was done in the VAB building, but again, same rules apply. If you just try and get on the runway as quickly as possible, try and avoid this obnoxious transporter that's getting in the road. But if you try and centre it as quickly as possible, and then you can stick the wheels to the tarmac, and then just hold the X button to brake. The Rufus baby, and they've conveniently put a telepoint right at the end of the level. It'd be a bit unfair if you had to travel all the way, you know, like if you had to go and rescue the, or you had to transform into Rufus back on the space station. On that note, I'm not going to test it just for the sake of time, but I have a sneaking suspicion that right at the end there is basically how you would get back up to the space station if you had discovered that you'd actually forgotten something and you wanted to go back up. But of course, we haven't missed anything this time, so I'll just rescue this baby here and then proceed through the exit. And that is us done. So with the exception of that little mishap with the token there, that's pretty much everything done. Only took me about, let me see, I think it was probably about 45 minutes the first time I played through it. But it was a bit more sloppy this time. It didn't really affect too much, I suppose, but it was just like a couple of unnecessary transformations that added on a few minutes, and then the whole debacle with that token there. But everything's collected now, all the babies for this entire world, so that puts us well over the limit that we need to go for saving Claude, which is 65 babies, I believe. We've completely blown past that at this point, and we've also blown past the 1,000 token mark. I should have pointed that out in the last video. We only needed 20 as soon as we started the VLF facility, and that put us into the like over the 1,000 mark, so woohoo! 1,000 tokens. And with that, I'll basically cut this video here, and then next time I'll be completing saving Claude. See you then.